right, day at the beach with my friend Shawarmas, and we are at the famous
Juhu Beach.
And this is a place where people come to chill out, hit the waves, and people swim here? You guys don't swim here?
No.
So forget the waves, they're here to eat, right?
Definitely.
Yeah?
Let's just eat and leave.
Okay, so we're gonna go do some eating, street food. Let's do it. So as soon as we walked up to the stalls, like, people are already coming up to us, trying to grab us.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But you guys know where to go, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Exactly. All
right, let's follow. I'm gonna follow them. So. Lead the way to good food. First stop is we're gonna get some pavaji.
Yeah.
This is the first thing I ate when I came to India. And you guys said it's really good here.
Yeah. Generally this place, yeah.
And this is different than what I think I had before. This is a little more tomato based, I feel like.
Yeah.
Now, is it normal to have like a half a stick of butter in my pavaji?
Not as much as that place, though.
Okay. All right, first stop, pavaji. I never get sick of this dish. First time I had it, I couldn't believe how much butter was in this. And this time as well, like, I mean, this bun is just doused with butter.
You can see your face, like...
it's glimmering.
Yes. Dunk some onions.
Yes, absolutely. Let's take the buns for a dunk.
Yeah.
This place, I feel like the sauce is more tomatoey, it's more a little more acidic, so it has more balance of the flavor between the butter. Does it have potatoes in there as well?
Yeah
there are a lot
potatoes.
Of potatoes.
Beans.
Cauliflower, beans, a lot of vegetables. And they have a specific pavbhaji masala.
Yeah.
Pavbhaji masala, bata do na.
So this is the masala that goes in the pavbhaji.
Yeah.
This is the essence of the pavbhaji.
Exactly.
Oof.
There's a lot of cumin in it, a lot of
cumin.
Fennel.
Yeah. No, this is great. So this is vegetarian.
Yeah, it's vegetarian. Most of the food you get around here is vegetarian. Yeah.
So it's healthy for me.
Not exactly.
So over here you can also grate some cheese on top of this.
You can grate some cheese pav bhaji, yeah.
Well, like I said, after the first day, I've been kind of like thinking about this dish. It's been on my mind. Love this. You guys got a good dish if you come here. One of my favorite dishes I've had in India so far. Oh my God. Whatever he's cooking is like, it's in my eye.
Yeah.
It's like food, spice gas. It's blowing over here. It's like, oh my goodness. So what is he making right now for us?
It's called masala pav.
Uh-huh.
So this, what we have, this is called pav.
The bun is called what?
Pav.
Pav, yeah.
Yeah, pav.
So this is also gonna be a pav.
Yeah, but it's just like plain pav with a lot of masalas in it.
Uh-huh.
And it's just that.
This guy's like Emerald. He's just like, bam. Ingredients go in, bam! Wow, I smell all that spices. Wow, it smells so intense right now.
He's gonna stuff it inside the
inside the bowl.
Yeah.
Oh.
I think so at least.
So there's our bowl.
Okay.
And he's slicing them like it's slices.
He's gonna mix it.
He took us by surprise as well.
Oh.
Yeah.
So you guys weren't expecting this.
No.
This is more like a stir fry with the bowl.
Yeah.
You guys ever had this?
No.
Oh, nice. Look at that. Ran into some cheese on that baby. Whew. You're the man. So this dish we got, again, is called the pav.
Masala pav.
Masala pav. And you guys were expecting just the bun.
Absolutely something else.
Season.
But yeah, he tricked us into this. So.
And he made this.
Even
when he never saw this before.
Never.
So we're all trying this for the first time.
Yeah, let's dig it.
Wow. What do you guys think? I think it's pretty darn
nice.
From what we've eaten before,
yeah.
It's very simple.
Mm-hmm.
But this guy's just spiced it up like every Bombayite would like it.
He turned this up by a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, this thing is really spiced up.
Yeah.
I like the pieces with the bun. You like the pieces with the bun?
Yeah. I'm eating only that.
Yeah. Because are you able to handle the spice?
No, not so much.
The bun,
it's
the
nice.
Pav soaks up all the,
yeah.
the oil and that masala
look
goodness.
At that.
Yeah,
look
yeah.
at that.
And it has that nice buttery.
Yeah.
Taste in there. It's
good, it's good.
Much flavor. I'm like, this is also borderline addicting right here.
Super.
We gotta go to the next place, guys.
Let's.
All right. You can't keep standing here eating this, okay?
Let them get a bite.
Yeah.
We have to try this.
All right, we can't. We gotta go, okay? You can't just stand here and eat this all day.
Let's go, Mike.
You gotta just.
Mike, no.
All right, we're gonna try one more. We're gonna try one more dish. This is the dish that would, that was blowing spice into my eyes. It's sort of a fried rice.
This is a tawa pulao.
So it is basically fried rice, kind of with the similar ingredients.
Absolutely, yeah.
That they made the previous three dishes.
Yeah.
Oh. Heck yeah with that rice. You guys think this is good, right?
Pretty good, yeah.
It is.
Really nice.
By the way, guys, these guys are trained chefs. So if they say it's good, you have to take believe it when I say it. If they say it's good, it's good.
You should mix it with the raita and try.
Mix it with the yogurt? Yeah.
It adds another flavor dimension altogether.
Yeah.
A little creaminess to it, a little
from the yogurt, from the yogurt, the sourness from the yogurt, yeah.
Oh, man.
So we do our rice very differently. Mm-hmm. We don't cook it all the way.
Yeah.
So it still has that bite to it.
A little authenticness. And this rice, I love because I'm not a big fan of sticky rice.
Yeah, no.
I don't like it when my grains are mixed together, like stuck together.
It's going to be apart. Yeah.
Yeah. In India rice, whatever flavor it is, it's always like separate grains.
Absolutely.
Very distinct. Guys. That was fantastic. Let's keep eating. There's more food, right?
Definitely.
So this is our way of making Chinese food. It's kind of different, but you should give it a shot.
Indian Chinese food.
Yeah, yeah.
So guys, what is this?
This is chili paneer. Paneer is cottage cheese.
Oh.
And it's sauce
that's
with
cheese.
Yeah.
Cottage cheese, yeah.
Cottage cheese.
Yeah.
This is stir-fried cottage cheese.
Yeah, it's stir-fried cottage cheese.
I didn't know you could stir-fry cottage cheese.
You can
do anything in Bombay, man.
All right, can't wait to try this. That is so interesting. If you guys didn't tell me that's cottage cheese, and you told me that was tofu.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
I believe you, it's really soft. It does remind me of Chinese sauce.
With the garlic, the ginger, the soy.
Yeah. A little sweet,
yeah.
Umaminess of the soy.
Right.
I didn't know this was possible. This is pretty darn good.
Yeah.
I could eat this over some rice. Like we take the fried rice we just had,
yeah.
Dump
yeah,
it all on
that.
We
do
that.
Yeah.
I think that's a great way to eat this.
It's very nice.
Like, do all that, get a lassi. That's a good Sunday afternoon, you know.
More than just a good Sunday afternoon. That's good every day, man.
My man, what's the second dish we're getting?
It's again a stir fry.
Uh-huh.
Balls made with shredded cabbage and carrots.
Let's do it.
This is gonna be absolutely a foreign taste for you.
Okay.
Because it's pretty different.
But it's supposed to be Chinese food. Come on, man.
Indian Chinese food, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm Chinese. Am I supposed to think of home when I'm eating this? But it's a completely foreign flavor to me.
Absolutely, yeah.
It looks like meatballs.
It's basically a lot of vegetables, beans, carrots.
Made into a ball.
Yeah.
That is fantastic. There's that beautiful chewiness.
It's a different mouthfeel altogether, no? Yeah.
The texture is insane.
Yeah, yeah.
Vegetarian dishes in the US, but oftentimes it's kind of boring. But this, if you want to be a vegetarian, come to India, like literally, you're eating great.
Great food, yeah.
This is vegetarian.
Yeah, absolutely vegetarian.
This is so creative.
It's good as well.
As a vegetarian dish. All right, well, let's get some more stuff before I like stuff my face even further. So we're gonna go eat some
shaved ice. Yes.
Look how pretty this is. Like there's so many bottles of different flavors. And just for you guys who are a little trying to be careful about eating street food, the water here is okay, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's bottled water.
Bottled water, okay. What do you guys usually get here?
See, the most authentic gola would be a kala kata gola.
Kala hata. What is
kala
that?
Kala means black, kata means sour.
Means sour.
Yeah.
So that's the most popular.
Yeah, so let's get that.
Okay.
You can also mix it with this one.
Mango green?
Yeah.
And you can ask them to put whatever you want.
Whatever
really?
You want.
All right, let's do it. How do you eat this? So
you like
let
slurp
it dip till it stops.
Yeah.
And then
just take a bite?
Yeah.
So I'm gonna bite the top thing, that's the mango.
Suck on it.
Yeah.
Oh, it tastes like there's some spices in there.
He's put some masala on top,
a blend of
masala on top.
He put some masala on top?
Yeah,
oh, he did. You can see the masala spices on the ice.
Yeah,
that's
sour.
Ooh, it's delightfully sour.
It is.
It's not like sour like
that
maybe you...
Cream a little bit.
It actually, it's good sour. It's like gentle sour. I like it. I actually like the sour better than the mango. I like the bottom better than the top. So this top is more sugary. The bottom is not as sugary. So basically people are just drinking the syrup, using this as like a little dip for the syrup.
Yeah, you dip it in.
Dip
and
it
then...
in, suck out the syrup on the bottom. You guys should get one too. I don't, this is kind of hard to share this. Like, hey, let me suck on this. Here, you suck on a little bit. So I got one and Xiao didn't get one. So he's gonna, you were complaining that this is too big.
Yeah, it just keeps going on and on.
Some people. it's too much food for you.
Exactly.
Give you too big a portion. I've never said that before in my life. All right, so after we finish sucking on this, which according to this guy takes a long, long time, and it's just a tiresome process, then we're gonna go get some more food. Stay tuned. So after the shaved ice, we went and got some nice fast food. Literally. It's called nice fast food. What are we having here?
This is baida roti with stuffed chicken. So it's a chicken roll.
It's a chicken roll.
Yeah.
And it has the mint, is mint chutney?
Mint chutney and the onions.
Love it. This tastes like a very Indian slash Chinese egg roll.
Yeah. It's a little salty though.
Which is why I feel like the onions do so well.
To cut that saltiness. Yes. It's really good.
I love the outside.
It's so crispy and flaky.
That is so nice.
That is amazing.
Beautifully spiced chicken on the inside. How they cook this chicken? Did they roast it, you think?
The skewers, you see, yeah. They just mince it up.
So
and then
this
they
is roasted chicken skewers,
yeah.
Basically.
Yeah.
I knew it has a smoky flavor to it.
It does.
Oh, that's great. All right, what else we got here?
So we got mutton seek rolls.
And mutton and butter?
Baida.
Baida.
So it's basically the roti.
Mm-hmm.
Egg is scrambled.
It's like a pancake. That looks good. I want to try this first.
Definitely, go ahead. I don't eat mutton.
You don't eat
so
mutton?
No.
Okay. You're really missing out here.
I know,
oh my god, this is awesome.
That. I can see that.
Oh my god. This thing is like eating a little stick of fire.
Yeah, it's that spicy.
It's spicy, but it's great. Cumin flavor, and this is so amazing. I could eat the heck out of this.
You already kind of did.
I am eating the heck out of this. That is so good. So this is the mutton pancake.
Yeah.
Do you see all that beautiful mutton in there? I think, what is that? What's that green stuff? It looks like maybe some pepper or green pepper.
I think the chilies.
This one is not, wait a minute. My mouth is all confused because it's like, it's still loving what I had before.
Uh-huh.
I love the outside pancake.
It's really nice and crispy and completely opposite to the texture of the filling inside. So it gives it a nice.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I just can't tell if it's spicy or not, where the spice is lingering from my last bite. So I'm just gonna make a switcheroo and go back to my gold skewers.
Now we're eating seafood, and it's about 8:30, almost 9 o'clock. And you guys said in India you don't eat dinner until 9.
No.
Nine's early.
Yeah.
I'm in bed by 9. I'm like, that's my routine. And he just brought over like a plate of fish. The fish is covered in how I like to bathe in chili. This is the greatest country on the planet.
That's a seafood feast.
Pretty much.
So what do we order?
That's pomfret.
Pomfret. Is that
pomfret?
Type of fish?
Yeah, it's a type of fish.
Uh-huh.
This is kingfish.
Kingfish.
That's Bombay duck. These are prawns.
Yep.
And that's salmon. It's called mutton sukha. That's chicken ghassi.
Uh-huh.
That's a prawn curry. These are clams. This is called vade.
Looks like a fried donut almost.
It's and this is neer dosa.
Rice, right?
It's made with fermented rice flour and coconut milk.
This
is the coconut chutney. So this is redundant if this isn't around.
Really?
Yeah.
So this is the essence of what we're eating today.
Absolutely, yeah.
Where do we start? Like, I don't even know what to do right now.
Let's start with the Bombay duck first.
Oh, I can already tell how freaking beautifully crispy this is.
It's almost like a chip, like a wafer.
Okay, so I'm putting on the essence.
You want to taste the essence just by itself?
I do want to taste the essence.
Yeah.
Because I need more essence in my life.
Oh, man.
That's good essence, man.
I'm good essence.
Ooh. That's your version of hot oil. Man, you should bottle this.
You taste the citrusy flavor first,
yeah.
And then the coconut hits a little bit later. Oh, see, there's the coconut about 10 seconds in.
And then the coriander, the mint,
yeah,
all that.
This has got some heat on there too.
Yeah.
All right.
Mm. Right to perfection. They're so incredibly tender.
Mm. It resembles bone marrow.
Mm-hmm.
You're right.
It's almost like butter, it just melts.
It melts in your mouth. It does.
Melt in your mouth, Bombay duck. That's actually a fish.
So what else are we eating here?
Let's try some of the pomfret.
Oh, look at that tender meat and all that beautiful chili sauce on the outside.
And you can see how this masala is all charred.
Yes.
But this still is like just half cooked.
Yes.
So it still has that naked heat that spice generally has. So you have these two like layers of masala, like one's absolutely charred and one still has that live.
And it looks so juicy. Oh my God. Oh.
Yeah?
Oh, you get that. Oh, you get that flavor right away.
Yeah, immediately.
You don't need anything else.
No, nothing. That's why I didn't ask for any of the essence.
We didn't put any
lime no essence,
anything?
Yeah, no.
Oh, God. You guys don't even understand.
Mmm. Mmm.
So,
You guys been dating for how long?
A year and a half now.
And you never told her about this place? How do you feel about that?
I don't feel very good. I don't want to be here.
I made the experience better because now she's here for the first time and you're here.
Yeah.
He's trying to cover it
that
up now.
That kind of helped.
But yeah, I'm sure you guys will be coming here a lot more after this.
Yeah.
So
if I survive, yeah.
What should we move on to next?
We should have some of the prawns for sure.
Thank you.
So what I like to do, mm-hmm. eat a prawn, obviously, to mm-hmm. taste what it tastes like at yeah. the beginning. Mm-hmm. But then I like to dip it in the prawn curry.
Prawn, oh. Sounds like a very smart plan. Yeah. So we're gonna take this and dip it in the prawn curry.
Yeah. Yeah. I learned it from my cousin.
Let's do it. Yeah. Cousin's a smart lady. Oh, wow.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. That curry, really light.
It's got that amazing coconut flavor to it.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's so good.
You should have the clams.
Yeah.
This is clams in a very traditional coastal masala. Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
Yeah?
Ooh. Oh, that flavor is like in your face, smacking your face.
Pretty much.
You taste the coconut right away. The fennel's strong too.
Try these.
Let's do it.
So you generally dip it in curries. This is the mutton. This is the chicken.
Mutton and chicken, okay.
Yeah. These don't go along with a lot of batter fried fish because okay. that's only the essence.
Yep. Wow. Wow.
So these masalas that you see,
yeah.
only recipes that you get masalas from the coastline.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't get this kind of food in Bombay.
Okay.
This couldn't be called local Bombay food. Mm-hmm. This would be called Konkani or coastal food or Gomantak food.
Coastal food. Okay. Yeah.
So now, you can use this to have the same dish.
Yeah. Wow, look at this. It's yeah. it's beautifully light.
Absolutely.
It is a little elasticy. Like, you guys have all the fun with your food games. I gotta catch up, you know? Some of that chutney. I'm gonna have two different types of fish in here.
Let's make it three.
Do it. Here we go. A little lime on everything.
Onion?
Oh, 100%. Here we go. Evil food
oh
scientist.
My God, that's a huge
that's a Mikey Chen bite.
Yeah.
One bite.
This is your moment.
Oh, yeah. This is everyone's moment. This is our moment. I'm eating for all of us.
Oh my God.
That bite is just everything. A little crunch, a little citrus, different textures of fish and prawn. Oh, all right, so before we wrap everything up tonight, we still got one more thing to eat. All right, so stay tuned. We're gonna finish everything here, and then we're gonna go eat something else one more time before we go to bed. And you guys don't go to bed. When do you go to bed? You're eating dinner at 10.
We can do something after that, and then again, and then
yeah,
again.
And then again.
We can eat till the cows come home.
Wow, I think that sounds like a plan.
Yeah.
See you guys in a bit.
Bye-bye.
All right, we stopped by for some shawarma after seafood, and we got a couple of different types.
Yeah.
This is the regular chicken shawarma. It looks delicious. It smells delicious. It most likely is very delicious. Then, I decided to go a little crazy and get the chocolate shawarma. Now, this isn't just chocolate syrup inside a pizza. It's chocolate
That's
syrup on top of chicken with yogurt.
And mayo.
And mayo.
And mint sauce.
And what?
And your mint chutney, cabbage and beetroot, pickled beetroot.
Now my question is, why does this exist? It must be
no
good.
Tea.
So you guys are like, no, don't you should eat that.
I wouldn't.
You know what?
But
I never even heard of it.
Yeah, we can try this.
Definitely.
All right, so let's, should we try that out?
It's up to you, whichever
yeah,
you
want. We should try that out.
Let's try this out. You want to take a bite?
No, you go ahead. You take the first bite.
Well, thank you.
That's a big bite.
Yeah?
This is amazing.
It's amazing. Thank you. Wow. The pizza is slightly toasted on the outside. The chicken, slightly charred.
Mm-hmm.
Wonderfully juicy. I haven't had a bad piece of chicken in India so far. Yogurt, creamy, delicious.
That.
I want to see your expression when you try it.
And then, that spice is hitting me a little bit too.
Yeah.
The chicken is marinated, the chicken is so juicy.
You can see the juices down.
All the way. I told you, listen to the locals. It's good?
Somebody was giving me the thumbs up sign, so I'm just reciprocating.
It's not bad.
I'm sure.
It's not bad.
But it's a little confusing when you first bite into it.
because luckily the yogurt is a little, yogurt could be a little sweet, it's okay.
Yeah.
So the chocolate syrup made the yogurt a little sweet, so you're kind of having like sweet yogurt. So then I get a little confused. I'm thinking, it's chocolate yogurt. So your mind's kind of telling you it's a dessert, right? Then you get a piece of chicken. And then you're like, oh wait, that's not dessert, that's chicken. And then it gets a little confusing. Then I'm just kind of like, is it good or not? So my conclusion is, it's not bad. It's also good if you like being confused. But just for a simple, single experience, I think it's all right.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What about this? You like that?
That's delicious. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So after this, we got one more thing.
Yeah, we do.
This is going to be awesome. Let's go.
Let's go.
All right, last place. Shaw asked me if I wanted to try a person he knows locally that makes ice cream by himself.
He does.
And it's awesome. So of course, we would love an ice cream cone.
You want it in a cone, or what I can ask him to do is bring it out one by one so you can taste each flavor.
Oh, really? Yeah. Let's do that.
We're going to try all the flavor he has.
Mix it into like patties. Look at that.
That's chiku.
Have you heard of chiku?
No, what's chiku?
What do you call it?
It's that we get here. I don't know. It's called chiku in English.
Chiku ice cream. Look at this. This is like the craziest ice cream.
Pista is
a pistachio.
Pistachio. Oh, yeah. Look at that.
And that's malai. That's like the classic. That's like the vanilla of kulfi. Malai is basically that when milk is cold, it forms a thick layer on the top of cream. Yeah. Malai means cream.
No, this is a cream ice cream.
Yeah, it's cream ice cream.
He actually asked me, you guys saw that tower of ice cream, right? Stack of ice cream. So he actually asked if I wanted to hold it.
Yeah.
I thought the same thing, right? I thought I was going to hold that thing and take a bite like an ice cream burger. I love this man. And what is this flavor again?
Malai.
It's cream flavored ice cream.
Cheers.
Oh my god.
Yeah, Mike?
Yes.
It is amazing.
Oh, I'm taking one more.
Oh, don't.
And even I need another one.
How long does it take for him to make all this?
5 to 6 hours.
5 to 6 hours? Yeah. How long has he been doing this?
23 years.
Every day?
23 years.
Every day.
Yeah.
I'm witness. I've seen him every day.
23 years. Every single day. I salute you, my friend. Wow.
All right. We're going to hurry this up.
Yeah.
It's melting. And then we're going to eat all the leftover ice cream in a really fun way.
Wow. Look at the little.
That is rose.
That's rose?
Yeah. Rose petals.
Rose petals.
What? That's rose petals.
God.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh.
It's so minty. It's so good.
I'm my favorite one. Oh my god.
Magician.
Chia seed rose syrup.
Sari dal.
All of it in there.
Sari dal.
Nice.
Thank you.
Woo.
Faluda with like 6 different types of ice cream. Yeah? Hope you're seeing the joy on my face. It looks like this.
You just came to where I live and taught me how to have Faluda.
Hey, you know what? I don't believe there's an ice cream mixture that's wrong. You know, you can add all the different types of flavors of ice cream together. It can only get better. That's my belief of it all. Yeah? She's like, nah. Hey, you know what? You gotta appreciate the ice cream. Wow, guys.
So food.
We're good?
So food.
What a fun, another fun food day with you guys. So glad I met these guys because that's what I love. I love going to different countries and meeting you guys, you local folks who can really show me where really good food is, because you know. So it's so great running into you guys. I don't believe in coincidences. I think everything happens for a reason. We are connected by the fates. Exactly.
Yeah,
food gods connected us, and we were able to go to a lot of great places. So thanks to you guys so much for taking me to all these awesome places.
It's been amazing.
Yeah. So, man. Till next time.
Definitely.
Look me up in New York. I'll take you guys around for a change. And thank you guys so much for watching. And until we all meet again.